Oh,
hello.
I didn't see you there. My name is Maximilian. I'm 17 years old. I'm street trials rider in Sweden.
Welcome.
My channel. Hello, my name is Maximilian. Today we're going to do a bike check, including gear check on what I ride 2016. The bike, the gear, thoughts, new things that I could get, probably recommendations. Let's do it. Okay, so yeah, I got myself the Inspired Fourplay, the team version. I think the cranks is the cheaper option, but it works. It's really a sick bike, all stock right now. Planning on changing some things to get into the parts. The forks and frame is Inspired Fourplay gloss red, getting them blades. Looks sick. The fork, I put in some elastics so I can do my foot cast without destroying anything. So the wheels, it is the Holy Roller from Maxis. Really fast, they are 2.4s, like most G-Trials, 1.4 inches, work really great. The rims are Inspired team, front and rear. Hubs, okay, too ill. Sounds cool, looks great, moves along nicely, good go out of box. That is the wheels. Brakes, Hope Trialstone 3, front and rear, they are amazing. The caliper is also Trialstone from Hope. Extra big to fit those extra large pads that makes the brakes stop. It's an overall very good performance. Couldn't be more happy. The pedals, Inspired team pedals, they, you know, not the best part on the bike, I'd say. Jumping over to the drivetrain side. On this bike comes a chain tensioner from Trialtech and I love it. Got the relative offset crank, 175 mm. Bottom bracket is a relative howitzer. The bash ring, which is just great, big component. The relative trials bash ring, top notch. Seat, it is the Inspired Pivotal Kevlar. Looks nice. Seat post is an Inspired Pivotal. Think about that, kids. I'm talking to you as well, Yanni. Inspired seat clamp. Okay, so over to the steering. Okay, are you ready for this? FSA Orbit headset, stem, Trialtech Sport, 90 mm, grips, Inspired lock-ons, the handlebars, Inspired high-rise riser, specially made for this bike. That's pretty sick. When you're on that front wheel, you really get the feel for it. Great. Some special things with the geometry from this bike: short chainstay and the low bottom bracket to make it a really good for modern street riding. It's maneuverable and yeah, that is great. The tubes by the seat and by the chainstay specially designed to make it extra tight and smooth in the back. Great performance. The final thing, the weight. The weight of my bike is 11.3 kilograms including the pedals, and yeah, I think it works great. It's an amazing bike. Performs well, sturdy, good to learn on, high performance bike. So the cost of this bike right now, £1,789 at most sites. Pretty expensive. It was totally worth it. It's an amazing bike. Okay, so things that I would like to change would probably be the pedals. The pedals haven't performed as well as I had hoped. Might get some new ones. New proof, I think. Also the grips, I need new ones. On my slopestyle bike, I ride the This Is The Boss by Andrew Lacombe. So I'll probably have a pair of them. I would probably get some new tires as well. Not that these ones don't work out great, but I know for a fact that the Gasquet Pro model on Continental, they would work out great on this bike, I think. So why would I get them? Come on, it's Dan McGaskill. It's a pro mode. Why not? They are fast, sleepy, and they're Dan McGaskill. Nothing to argue about. So they are called Dan Gaskill Air King from Continental, as I have already said. Pedals, tires, grips. And yeah, that's the bike. Let's get into my gear. And so now let's get into the gear I'm using. Everything but the gloves are things I've tried out for a long while. I really recommend every single bit of it. It's just high performance stuff. First of all, what I think everyone should get in their collection, a good pair of padded, stretchy trail pants. They are the best thing you've ever gone and tried. They sit tight to your skin. They make you feel really comfy. The looks of them, you might not like, maybe you do, maybe you don't. I think they're pretty cool. Next thing, a lot of times you don't feel like riding the trail pants. Then I ride my box quads. They are great for riding. They are really comfy. They will keep you from scratches. The only thing that's missing is probably a pocket. As to that, they are great. Coming up, the gloves. I've ridden them once. It's the Yetzi Airtime. They are red and black. I can't talk much about them because I haven't ridden them for long, but yeah. They seem to work fine. Protection. I got the 661 shin guards. I think they are the 2015 ones. And they will save your ass if you slip a pedal. So, shin guards, it's the one protection gear you always need to use. It's the best ones that I have found, and I've ridden them forever. Totally recommend them. Two things left. They are amazing. Helmets. The Daniel Dumphy Art Design helmet. I can't really stress this enough. It's the best helmet you will ever get. It fits so snug that even when you forget to close your helmet, it won't fall off. Just amazing. Look at it. I mean, gosh, it's amazing. You get the fire sand in front. Then it's the TSG logo. Looks like this. It's pretty nice. I love it. And so, to last, my shoes. 510 free ride. VXI. I knew that all the time. Okay, so they are really good. They are so professional at 510. They do it nice. Their service is over the top. And I will never buy shoes from another brand. They are the best. They got the stealth rubber technology, which means they are sticky as hell. I mean, if you put your foot on that pedal, you won't slip, unless you really try to. Go and buy yourself a pair, because they are great. So this is the end of my first video. There will be more up soon, and I hope you liked what you saw. Feel free to like, maybe subscribe, leave a comment, and I will see you next time.